The following program is brought to you by Kevin Shorey Ministries and our family of friends.
Hey, we're going to have a great program today. We are in crazy praise-a-thon mode. We are giving him
makes no sense,
but we're still going to give him praise.
Yes.
Because we have a mountain in front of us.
Ooh.
But we're going to speak to that mountain this week as we've done all week. We thank you for those who've been calling in, those who have been going online. We don't know if you've written yet because the letters haven't got here, but I'm sure you've written, and I'm thankful so much in advance for what God's going to do. We are going forward in praise. So get ready for our great program today with Pastor Gerald Stewart and Ron Childress and the True Connections Band. Roll it. It's the Kevin Shorey Show, taped before a live studio audience in the Branson Mill in Branson, Missouri. Today, Kevin's special guest, Ron Childress, and the sometimes funny but always co-host, Justin Aller. A special week of Praise-a-thon with Crazy Praise. Here's your host, Kevin Shorey. Welcome to the Kevin Shorey Show. Isn't it a great day to serve the Lord? Come on, let's give him praise. We are giving him praise. Come on, band, let's give him some praise. Come on, just have some praise-a-thon music. We have a special band. We might as well take advantage of it. Come on and give me that kind of that praise. True Connections is here all the way from Arkansas. And Pastor Ron Childress, Pastor Gerald Stewart, one of our great friends of this and partners of the ministry, is here. And
it's going to be a good day, Kevin.
It's a great day to serve the Lord. Just right before we went on the air, June from Akron, Ohio says, I'm calling just to tell you, Kevin, how much we enjoy the program. Kevin wakes me up in the morning with the Word of God.
Huh.
And I love his programs, his television programs and television shows like this. He lets us know it's going to be a wonderful day.
Yes.
And we are blessed with his ministry. Thank you, Kevin Shorey. Have a blessed day.
Awesome.
Thank you, June, out there in Akron, Ohio. It is a great day. Our family of friends that give monthly, every month.
Do we have new ones for the map?
We have ones we haven't mentioned yet. Yeah, they give faithfully $33 every month. We send you a gift. You don't have to ask for it. We just send you a thank you for giving $33. And we want to build on that. If you can do that in 2017, $33 a month, we're doing that. We're throwing out that dollar vote. I don't have any new votes in, but if you're out there watching, everybody can throw a dollar.
Here, so.
It's empty out there. Come on, Montana.
Come on,
Utah, Colorado. I know you're out there. Oregon. I know Oregon's got to be out there. Mississippi's out there. Alice in Mississippi is one of our family of friends.
Where in Mississippi?
It's Mize, Mississippi.
Oh, that's kind of down here.
Right down in there. I know. You're good at geography there, buddy.
Here we go.
That's right. Ruth in Burlington, Kansas. Hi,
Ooh.
Ruth. Thank you so much. She gives extra
that.
All the time, too, especially in our telethon month. She's already given some extra for this telethon week. Carol in Saginaw, Michigan. You got Saginaw, Michigan out there?
Michigan.
Yeah, Michigan's way over here. We got Michigan now.
There.
All right. Thank you, Michigan. Robert in Paso Robles, California.
Paso Robles.
Paso Robles.
Yes.
Paso Robles.
It's
on the map right there. Look
awesome.
At that. Yeah,
there
we're filling it up, and we're thankful for that. We have a new shout-out. A new shout-out with the $1,000.
Yes.
We need 100 people to give $1,000. That's what's going to get us through to the next week. We are not crying wolf. There will be no more shows on February 1st. If we don't get those who will help. We have the debt.
So we are sending out the SOS.
Save our stations. It's not going to be on this piece of paper. There's actually a big wooden
plaque. We're going to build a plaque.
Yes, with the lifesaver there and your name on this plaque. And we are going to have those who answered the call of the SOS and threw out that life raft to us.
Let's fill that plaque with names.
Let's fill it with names. Please do that. We had a great program yesterday with Gary McSpadden and the McClintocks.
Amazing.
Gary had another word for us which on the after show.
Yeah.
You need to watch us on Roku or KevinShorey.com. You can watch us live every day.
WJAN.
Even if we don't end up on television, we'll always be there on our new network. What is it called?
WJAN.
Which stands for?
We Got a Network.
We Got a Network. That's right. So we always on that Roku.
Roku!
We don't say yoo-hoo. We say Roku. Okay.
Yes.
We are going to show you what the word that God gave Gary McSpadden for us, for this ministry, and for you. Watch this. I know it will bless you as it blessed me. Roll it.
I believe that God has raised up kings in the earth and priests. Sometimes we lump those together in a way that makes it sound like we're all preachers and we're all kings. We are to rule and reign, but I believe there's a division there.
I
believe what God has done is raised up priests and he's raised up kings. If you'll read the Old Testament, you'll find that in every situation where there was a godly king, he would always go to the priest. The priest would have a word for him. The priest would speak into him and would pray for him. And the king would go into battle and bring the spoils of the war back. And I believe that's God's plan for today. And what we've done in the church is anytime we've seen somebody with an anointing, we said, well, you need to be a preacher, you need to be a missionary, you need to be a pastor. But that's a priestly calling. I believe God has called kings into this earth to provide for the ministry of the gospel. Because when the spoils came back, the king always blessed the priest, the house of God, always.
Right.
So when we're talking about what you're going through right now, I believe God wants to use the kings of this earth that have the anointing of the kingly anointing and the call of Gabriel, which is what this is about, to pour into your ministry. So I want to talk to every businessman for a moment. You tuned in today, you're watching, and it's not by accident. The profits that you're making are from the hand of God. You have an anointing to make money. I've known a lot of people. I didn't understand how they did it, but everything they touched turned to gold. I don't have that anointing. Now, I turn people who are not Christians into Christians.
Amen.
I turn people who are struggling into victors. My calling is that. But there are others whose calling is not that. But as a king's anointing sits upon you, God did that for a purpose. And I believe the purpose is to bless the kingdom of God. We need businessmen and businesswomen. We need owners of businesses. We need people who are able to make money to bless the kingdom of God. You know, there's a religion out there right now who's understood this better than the Christians.
Oh, tell it.
They buy up whole towns. All the employment in town is run by this religion.
Yeah.
You know why they do that? All the shops are owned by this people of this religion. You know why they do that? So they can fund destruction on the very people that God has called.
Come on.
The destruction that comes out of that. They understand funding. They understand that the funding has to come from somewhere. They go into business. They create profit. They use that money to kill and steal and destroy. Well, I read in John 10, that's the work of the devil. God's called abundance into our lives, and I believe you need to be sure that you are providing for the priestly anointing as those who have the kingly anointing. Now, can I say this? If you've always wanted to start a business, never had the knowledge, March 3rd and 4th at Faith and Wisdom Church, we're doing a Friday night and a Saturday, Gabriel's Call, 8 hours of training and teaching. We want you involved in that. Those of you who now have businesses, you want to know how to do it better. Dr. Peter J. Daniels, a billionaire who started with absolutely nothing, gave his life to God at a Billy Graham crusade, and then gave his life to God in his businesses. He is a great man of God.
Yes,
he will teach us the principles of how to make our businesses better for the glory of God. And this is only in the local church.
That's awesome.
Here's the mandate he received from the Lord. 100 million Christian business people creating 100 million Christian business people creating $200 billion for the kingdom of God in the next 20 years. You can be a part of that. So we want you to come. We want you to be involved in it. March 3rd and 4th, you can call our church. We can tell you how to be involved in that.
Awesome. Thank
but you
Pastor.
Would be blessed by that, Kevin. Yeah, yeah. The whole thing about this is that God wants the ministry to be blessed. And we as people of God, we call on those who... I would almost guess that most of your gifts are from folks who are struggling to get to you what they're getting to you.
Right, right.
But there are others sitting out there that has banks, accounts full of money that don't turn loose.
They could pay the debt without even
pay
a sacrifice to them. Yeah.
I call on those people to release that.
Amen.
Turn that loose. Release it unto the Lord and send a gift today.
Amen. Amen. Do that today. Thank you. Isn't that a great word from Pastor McFadden?
Brother.
And we're back. Powerful word. Now is the time to move. Now is the time for action. We're in Praise-a-thon. Let's just praise him. It's not just for us. We do need a miracle, but maybe you need a miracle today too. God has given us this opportunity for us together to receive that miracle, to praise him in the middle of situation. When Paul and Silas were thrown in prison because of accusations, it was all about money, what it was, and the fortune tellers had lost their money, so they put them in prison. But what did they do in the middle of their prison when they felt locked up, when they felt like, wow, we can't minister anymore? You know, sometimes we feel like that. We talk about it in our staff meeting every day. What if we can't worship? Why we can't do this program anymore? We'll be locked up and our hands tied. Well, they began to praise him, and the place began to shake, and the jailhouse began to shake, and the prison doors burst open, and they were set free. That's where we're at right now. And no matter what you're facing, that's where you can be. Right? My favorite pastor. Come on, one of my favorite pastors in the whole wide world who prays for me, is one of my family of friends. Ministers to me all the time, prays for me when I'm sick, prays for me when I'm well. He's always praying for me. He writes me. They support me. He and his beautiful wife, Edith, are great ministers of the gospel. Pastor Gerald, what do you want to tell the people today?
I want to tell you today that God is faithful.
Yes.
I've served the Lord for 68 years. I know that he is faithful. He has always been faithful. He has touched me many times with healing. He's touched me with the anointing of the Spirit. And a special word for you in the audience today. God is not unmindful to forget your faith and labor of love.
That's right.
In that you do minister to the saints and do minister. Paul encouraged the people that God will not forget you.
Amen.
When you are obedient to him.
I need to hear that myself. Come on.
Paul said, let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of faith.
Yes.
That we may find mercy and grace to help in time of need. You are in need today. I am in need. This ministry is in need. We must have the people of God turning around and saying we're not going to allow the devil to destroy something that God has raised up.
Come on.
God is on your side, my brother, my sister.
Yes.
God is on your side.
Yes.
The devil is not, but God is.
That's right.
And God plus you will win every battle that you come against.
Hallelujah.
And the Holy Spirit and Jesus. And that makes you a quartet. And four is greater than one.
That's right. Amen.
And you remember that when Jehoshaphat was in trouble, the enemy was coming from every direction across below the Dead Sea. And God said to them through a prophetic word, which I give to you today. God said, tomorrow you go out and meet the enemy.
That's right. That's right.
For I will give them into your hand.
Come on now.
And when he said, you go out in the morning, and the king appointed singers and musicians to lead the band.
That's it.
And when he led the band, it said the enemy was defeated. They came to the cliff.
Come on.
And all of them were dead.
All of them. Come on.
Not one left.
Pastor, you don't even know this, but that's what I've been preaching from that Chronicles 20 all week long. You
praise
just showed
God.
Up. Well, we're on the same page, brother.
Jehoshaphat
won the victory through praise. Come on.
Praise God. And when you sing in praise, there is victory.
Yes, sir.
The devil does not like you and me to sing and pray. If he can shut us up, he has won the battle.
He ain't going to shut me up.
But the
Come
people
on.
Of God are never to shut up.
That's right.
You keep going.
Come
you
on.
You keep going no matter what comes against you.
Come on.
Don't give up. The worst thing about falling down, the worser thing is refusing to get up. And God says if you even fall a little bit, get up.
Come on.
I'm with you and I'll stand with you.
Come on.
And my brother, my sister, when David came to the with 600 men down in the desert, and I've been in those deserts. I know what it's like to be in the deserts of the Middle East. I was in the service there. I want to tell you, when David came to that brook, Besor, 200 of the 600 were so faint, they could not walk another mile. They couldn't go anywhere, they're so tired. And so David and 400 men left 200 tired, worn out men of God, men who are on the battlefield.
Come on.
But their strength gave out. And with 400 men, God gave a mighty victory.
Yes, hallelujah.
And here comes the people, it says the evil people with David's crowd, said, we are going to give these people their women and their children, send them home empty. David said, no way, no way.
Right.
Those that stand by the stuff gets the same reward as those who go with the stuff.
Yeah.
And God wants you to know you're the one who stands by the stuff. You can't go on television. You can't go around the world. But you can stay by the stuff. And today we need your stuff.
Yeah.
Right here for this ministry.
That's it, Pastor.
Supply the need for the work of God.
Yes.
And God will bless you.
Yes, sir.
And then it said, David, they took 3 days to get the spoil. It was so much.
Come on now.
And when Jehoshaphat was down in the valley,
yeah,
it took them 3 days.
That's
to
right.
Gain
they got all the
all
spoils.
Of the victory and supplies that they needed. And my brother, the Holy Spirit is speaking to you wherever you are, whatever your need, go out to do battle for the Lord. Go out to do battle over this television ministry. You are the ones who propel this ministry. God wants you to do something now.
Amen.
God wants you to pick up that phone, and he wants you to call. He wants you to write. He wants you to send a telegram or whatever way you get. Send it by mail. God says, join my army.
Come on now.
And I will
That's
give
it.
You the victory.
Oh, I believe
because
it.
You are not in defeat. You're in the victory mode.
Yes.
Thanks be unto God for his glorious, victorious gift. And in this ministry, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, I pray now for everyone here.
Yes,
and all across
us,
the world.
Come on, pray for
that
us.
That the Spirit of God will touch them. Let them know that they're on the battlefield for the Lord.
Jesus.
And that they're going to succeed because Jesus Christ never gave up. He succeeded in the face of all kind of opposition. And these people are going to do the same. They're going to rise up right now and say, Pastor Kevin, I am on the side of the Lord. I am on your side. I am on the side of God.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your word. Speak to us, Jesus.
Thank
you, Lord.
Yes. 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 Yes, we are in victory. In the name of the Lord, victory. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Got victory today. Victory today. Thank you, Pastor Gerald. I love you, Pastor Gerald. I love you with all my heart. Respond to God's word. David was told he could recover all if we go pursue. He says, God, what should I do? He said, pursue and recover all. I'm telling you, we're going to pursue. We're going to go forward. Pastor Ron Childress is going to come up here. We got about 9-10 minutes, Pastor. Come on up here and complete the word, what God's going to do. Ron, Pastor Ron, I just believe you need to stay over to tomorrow's program too, and we're just going to continue. And do like David said, don't just sit back, because you can even receive a word like you just received, and you can say, well, that's a good word. Boy, I felt it. I feel good. Oh, yeah, I feel good all over. But you know what? If you don't do anything about it, all you get is goosebumps. All you get is a good feeling. But if you want to recover all that the enemy's tried to steal from, oh, I'm on my soapbox already. If you want to recover all then pursue for what's coming to you. David was told at Ziklag, you got to go and pursue, and you shall recover all. And that's exactly what happened. You don't get anything by good intentions. It's by moving forward in action and doing as the word of the Lord tells you. Don't do what I say. Don't do what a great pastor says. Do what God tells you to do. If you do what I say, you're going to get my blessing. I can't bless you much. But if you do what God tells you to do, he can bless you abundantly. Pastor Ron, give a nice hand to Pastor Ron Childress for coming all the way here from
Gasville, Arkansas.
From what is it now?
Gasville.
Gasville. I was just about to say Duckville. I don't know why. From Gasville.
And
tell me the names of your guys over here as they show a picture of the True Connections banner. On the keyboard?
On the keyboard.
And the saxophone?
Got Brother Dale Adams.
Yes.
On the
guitar?
Yellow guitar. I call it a cupcake.
Don't stop
Brother
playing.
David
we in telethon.
Sutterfield.
Yeah, just,
and on the second lead is Brother Robert Larson.
Yes, sir.
On the little bungos is Brother Butch.
All right, Brother Butch. Glad they're here. Thank you for bringing them.
I am so glad to be in the house of God today.
I tell you.
And you know what?
Come on.
A good feeling.
Tell me.
I know.
By the way, Pastor Gerald left an offering too.
Amen.
He doesn't just speak words. You know, anybody can talk the talk, but he walks the walk. But go ahead. What's the Lord telling you?
It's gonna be all right.
Yes, sir. Oh, come on now.
Everything that God has said.
I need a hanky to wave. Come on. I need to wave something.
It's gonna be all right. Just like the master have said.
I believe it. I receive it.
You know, when you're going through a battle, he said, raise your hand and praise the Lord, because it's going to be all right.
Yes, yes.
It's all right.
Yes.
It's all right right now. Before I say another word, basharabiket today.
Come on now. Holy Spirit is speaking.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
You know what? I'm looking. There's many of you right now that God is speaking to your heart. And I know this one thing. This ministry has met many, many, many needs. There was a young man. There was an older man. The only show that he would watch was yours.
Didn't like Christian television or anything to do with God.
Didn't watch it. Mm-hmm. But when you would come on, he would set in attention, and he was full alert, saying, this is good.
Yes.
Now, he went on to be with the Lord.
Yeah.
But through what you was preaching, and at the end of it, you gave an invite.
Yeah.
And he gave his heart to
the Lord.
Gave
his heart to He's in heaven now because of this program.
Because
of what
program.
You were doing. Yeah.
And you can't neglect what God is doing. You know, I was reading there. In Psalms 103, don't forget the benefits. Now, no matter what you're going through, if you make God first, God will never, ever let you down.
That's right. I promise
you.
That's right. Yes, sir.
Because he is a miracle-working God. Many, many, many days the Lord has stepped in and just worked it out. You know, I was believing God for a new truck, and I went to get in debt, and God began to deal with my heart. He said, give. If you want to get out, give.
That's it.
That you might get in.
It's the opposite of the world's standards.
There you go.
But
the
God's
standard
kingdom
of
is,
holiness.
Yes.
So, here was, I was looking at a vehicle like $35,000. And the Lord, one day, a guy came up to me and he said, no, God told me to give you this. And gave me a $42,000 pickup.
Come on now.
Paid for. So I'm believing God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost. Now listen, it ain't over yet. Mm-mm. No matter what the devil said, no matter what people think, say, or do, we have the victory.
Yes, sir. We have victory.
Just don't forget the benefits of what God is doing and what he said. Everybody that's watching, everybody across this country, one thing about it, we know that our God is able.
Yes,
and he will.
He will.
He won't let you down.
I know. I need to hear that today.
He won't let you down.
I know that, but I just love to hear the confirmation of that. And I love to hear it coming from you, brother, because
I'm a living witness.
Come on now. You have had Can I just say a hell of a month?
Thank you, Lord.
Brother,
but
you,
I made it.
You wouldn't know this. I mean, how long were you married?
12 years.
12 years. He lost his wife. His wife just passed away. To make it even worse, devil kicks you when you're down.
Your house burns,
catches on fire. I mean, can you say that's a hell of a week, right? That's everything, all in 1 week, right?
Everything bottom up. But thank God.
He shouldn't be here. He should be somewhere just depressed. But that's when the crazy praise comes in.
Woo!
When you know you've got the victory before you've even seen it. Oh, come
Hallelujah.
On.
Hallelujah.
When you're more than a conqueror, that means you don't just conquer. You're more than. You've seen the other side.
Well, you know what, Brother Kevin? I was in my bedroom, in a hotel. I was in a revival.
Yes, sir.
In Little Rock. Miracles after miracle after miracle. So when I got the call at 3:05 in the morning, and the told me that it had happened, you know, she was gone. And all of a sudden, you know how you get that anxiety and your heart begin to beat.
Oh, brother, I know that feeling.
And I got up out of my bed and I said, Lord, you told me to come here. You told me to preach. And souls was getting saved. And I said, now, if I ever had a miracle, I need you now. Mm. All of a sudden, I felt the peace of the Lord that came in that hotel room on the seventh floor. My heart quit, and it began to just settle. My blood pressure went down.
Come on now.
From that day, the destiny, all the grief,
that's it.
All the pain,
yeah.
All the hurt.
Yeah.
He reached in my heart and took it.
Yes. Sir.
That's why I say serving God is a benefit.
It's a benefit.
Helping this ministry is a benefit because it's reaching to the multitude of souls and people all of the country. So I support this ministry. I support it with everything I got.
Can you stay over to tomorrow's program for
we'll
me?
We'll be here.
Let me tell you, we offer silver that has health benefits and the Neo Relief. And there's a new, next week, it'll be out and available to you next week. It's Neo Relief Part 2 that helps restless leg syndrome and leg cramps. Those are great. Those will bring healing. But there's nothing that better that'll bring you the healing than the healing Jesus. That will help everything, not just physically, but mentally. Not just mentally, but in your soul and your spirit. He will calm your spirit. He'll give you a peace that passes human understanding. This is the Jesus we want to proclaim. Just think, if we weren't there when that man needed us, where he'd be right now, he'd be burning in a real hell. But he's in heaven today. And many more others. We can give you testimonies all day long. People healed, people saved, people delivered from drugs. Let me tell you, we need to hear from you today, but you know what? Those that are out there in the world, we want to reach the world. They need to hear from you today. We'll be back tomorrow to tell you again, Jesus is the answer for your world today. Thank you, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow.
Promotional consideration provided by Meyer Hotels.
The following program is brought to you by Kevin Shorey Ministries and our family of friends.